Anyways, this was another story. So we started this segment off with a really inspiring story. Yeah. We're going to finish it off with another really inspiring story. This one taking the internet by storm. Jack Foley getting the chance to meet Robin Lehner after the Islanders game the other night. And guys, we have the pleasure now of actually being joined on the show by Jack and his mother, Lauren. You guys, welcome to NHL Now. Yes. Thanks for doing this.
Hi, guys. Thank you so much for having us.
Well, I mean, I think congratulations are in order on many levels for you, Jack. How cool was it to meet your favorite player?
I was happy to meet him.
I figured you would be. What was that whole day like leading up to the opportunity to meet Robin? We saw the picture of the great hug between you two. What was the day like for you?
It was the best, even though that they lost. I'm like, oh, it's they're in Islander's zone. Hey, I'm meeting Robin Lehner. I don't care.
Jack, tell us. I mean, you got to meet the big guy all of a sudden after all this time. What's he like? What did you guys talk about? How'd that go?
He's a very nice man, and it went good. I'm happy when he gave me his stick.
Tell him about the hug.
Oh, I said to my mom when he gave me the hug, I'm like, my bones are gonna when Thomas Christ came out. Now he met me. I said to mom, I feel like my bones were gonna crack. That's how hard he was hugging.
Aww, that's how you know it was a genuine
hug. That's a good
hug.
That's what I told him.
That's awesome.
Exactly what I said.
Is that, Jack, is that the stick in the background that we see? Can you show it off for us?
I got both of them.
Oh, you're kidding me.
God.
Very nice.
Oh, that's awesome.
Super cool.
Well, I got to ask, now that you're in with the cool kids, I mean, these are your friends now, is there any chance you're going to get out to a playoff game?
Fingers crossed. We're hoping.
Well, let's go. We're on the national stage now, so we just put it out there. Yeah, you never know what's going to happen, right?
Hard to say no now, wouldn't it
be? Yeah, exactly.
NYI.
That's right.
Hey, Lauren, you know, we're so happy for Jack and for your family. We saw the whole, started with the checklist there. And, you know, you guys have all been through, I would imagine, so much over these last several years. It must be exciting for you to have this opportunity to kind of really enjoy the fact that, boy, you got such a cute little boy there.
Absolutely. I'm just, as his mom, and, you know, we all want the best for our kids. We always want, you know, the sun, the moon, and the stars for them. But, you know, it's a little extra special with me and my husband, with Jack, because he has been through so much. And, you know, and he will continue to go through a lot with his health journey. So we just want all the hockey opportunities that he can drum up now.
That's great. Hey, Jack, I got to ask you, my friend. I mean, there are lots of folks that are my age, that are EJ's age, Jackie's age. They go through heart procedures, you know, the surgery that you did, and they don't have the same kind of courage. How'd you get to be so brave, buddy? How'd you get to be so brave?
It's just a thing.
It's just a thing?
It's just
my uncle.
What about your uncle?
He was a 9/11 firefighter.
He was, wow. And that's where you get some of your inspiration and some of your courage, I'll bet, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah, really cool deal. Lauren, tell us a little bit about what was it like? I mean, I'm sure you've had plenty of interaction with the Islanders behind the scenes before Jack and Robin ever get put together. What was your experience like in dealing with the NHL club?
A lot of people have said this to me before we ever even met any hockey player, that hockey players are the best. And it's absolutely true. Anybody that we've dealt with has just been so gracious, so heartwarming, generous. I mean, even the fans, it's just amazing. It's a wonderful, hockey's just a wonderful family. I mean, you know, all these people went out of their way for him and they don't even know us. And it's just, it's amazing.
It's been one of the best and most inspiring stories of this hockey season, because we cover a lot of that stuff on this show. Part of the list of accomplishments, though, for Jack was that he also got back on the ice to actually play hockey. So I just wanted to ask you guys, how cool of a moment was that for you, Lauren, to kind of see him get back out there and do something that people told him he wasn't going to be able to do?
It's amazing. My husband and I sit in the stands all the time, and we're the crazy parents who are crying and everybody's like, what's wrong with them? But, you know, it's every time he gets out there, it's one more time that they said he wouldn't. Mm-hmm. And so it just means the world to us. It's a miracle. It's a miracle on ice.
Very well said. Listen, we appreciate the time. Congratulations again. We wish you guys nothing but the best moving forward. And I hope you guys end up at a playoff game somehow.
Thank you. Us too. Can Jack give a quick shout out to two of his hockey buddies?
Of course. The stage is yours.
Who do you want to say hi to?
Michael and Thomas.
All right. It's good to have friends, Jack.
Let's make that number 4 check come true. Islander for a day. Jack
Holden.
All right. I like it.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you guys so much. We appreciate it.